So I will tell, then we'll start, no?
Yes, sir. Good afternoon all, and welcome to the online class of Odisha State Open University. And today we'll be discussing about issue of debenture. As all of us know, in the previous class, we have already discussed about the accounting treatment of share, share capital, and issue of shares. And today we'll be discussing the next topic, that is issue of debenture. And mostly we'll be discussing the procedure of issue, types of debenture, and accounting treatment of debenture, and redemption of debenture also. And for this, we have Prashant Kumar Behra, sir, as our resource person, and he is now working in St. Mary Junior College as a lecturer of commerce, and he will be delivering a lecture regarding this issue of debenture. And may I please request all the participants to please mute their microphones and to avoid unusual disturbance. And if you have any questions or queries, you can please type in the chat box, and all of your queries and questions will be answered at the end of the session by our resource person. Now, may I please request Mr. Prashant Kumar Behra, sir, to start the session. Please, sir.
Yes, sir. Just only I am to tell one thing only, that in between also I'll ask the doubts also sometimes, because the child, suppose the one student is able to understand or not. In between, they can, the conversation little bit will be going on. Okay, sir. Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes. Okay. Okay. Good afternoon, everybody. So, just only I have to ask something about the John Stock Company. Anyone know idea about the John Stock Company? Because sir only just told before that you have learned about the shares. To the shares and the issue, the treatment, accounting treatment of shares, suppose you know, then it is better to understand. It is very easy to understand you about the debentures also. So first of all, just only giving the introduction about the John Stock Company. So John Stock Company is an artificial legal person created by law. Just like suppose you are starting a business, one person business. When one man is starting a business, no legal formalities are required to start a business. So he can arrange the capital easily. He can use his own capital, or he can take the loans from the banks, small amount. Because in the one man business or the sole trade business, the owner required very small amount of capital. So he can arrange funds by himself or may take loan from the banks. But when they wants to increase the capital, then the partnership business can be started. There are two or more persons are required to start a partnership business, and where the capital is provided by the partners. But when I'm telling about the joint stock company, the company requires huge amount of capital. The company requires huge amount of capital. And this capital the company arranged through medium-term and long-term sources of capital. There are various ways there how the company is, what are the sources, different sources of the capital arranged by the company, John Stock Company specially. And this company also having the private company and the public company. Just only giving the introduction about a private company and public company. Private companies are those companies where there is restriction on the issue of shares. You know better, because already the shares chapter are covered by you. But the public company, there is no restriction on the issue of shares. The public company can issue shares for capital arrangement. The company can also take loans from the bank. The company also may issue the debentures. So you have learned about the shares, just like anyone can tell about the shares. What do you mean by share? In between also conversation should be there. Any student, you can tell about the share?
Sir, you please finish the session, then we will interact with the students, sir.
Okay, sir. Okay, okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So, debentures. About this, the study of this chapter would enable you to understand about the meaning of debenture. You have already learned about the shares, so you can know about the difference between the debenture and the share. What are the difference? Because shares also and debentures also, these are the sources of capital for the joint stock company. And you learn about the types of the debenture, what are the different kinds of debentures are there, how the debentures can issue by the company, different types of debentures. Then issue of debentures for cash. When the company issue debentures for cash, means the company will get the cash from the debenture holder. And these debentures can issue at par. Par means the same face value. Whatever the face value of the debenture, it is issue at par means same cost. And at premium. Premium means when the debentures are issued at higher than the face value. If suppose 10 rupees is the debentures cost face value, and when the debentures are issued at more than 10 rupees, that means it may be 12 rupees or 15 rupees. That is called when the debentures are issued at premium. That means the market value of the debentures is more than the face value. And at discount. Discount means when the market value of the debenture is less than the face value. If face value is 100 rupees and the company wants to issue the debentures at 98 or 97 rupees, then it is called the debentures are issued at discount. Then we'll go the issue of debentures for consideration other than cash. Means when the sometimes what happens, the company purchase the fixed assets, plant and machinery, or total business also purchased by the company. At that time, instead of getting the cash from the other person or any other company, the company will issue debentures to that person. So instead of getting cash, the company will issue debentures. That person will issue debentures. That is called debentures for consideration other than cash. An issue of debenture as collateral security. Collateral security means the additional security when the company take loans from the bank and the debenture issued to the bank as the collateral security or the additional security. You read details afterwards, I will tell. And next we'll cover about the accounting entries on issue when the debentures are redeemed at par and at premium. Then we'll learn about the accounting entries for the interest on debentures and writing of discount and loss on issue of debentures. So first one, I'm explaining about the meaning. Meaning of debentures. So what is debenture? It is a written acknowledgement of debt issued by the company. Suppose I'm giving the example, you are the debenture holder, means you want to purchase debentures from the company, any company. X Limited is a company and you want to purchase debentures from the company. Just like suppose you are having the fixed deposit in the bank, then what is the proof that you have a fixed deposit account in the bank? What is the proof? Because bank is issuing one certificate that Mr. Ram or Mr. Shyam having a fixed deposit account, he opened a fixed deposit account in our bank. So the bank is giving one certificate. That is the proof. Just like when one person is purchasing the debentures from the company also giving one proof, means the debenture holder, means who is purchasing the debenture, that person should have the proof that he has provided or he has invested some amount in the company. So here the company is taking loan from the debenture holder. So the company has to give a proof of document, one document. So it is a written acknowledgement of debt. The company has writing that company has taken debt from the person. That person is called the debenture holder. and it is an agreement for repayment of the principal amount. The company having the agreement with the debenture holder who purchased the debenture already. They are called the debenture holder, just like who is purchasing the share, they are called the shareholder. So here the company and the debenture holder having the agreement that the company has to repayment, or the debentures are redeemable. Redeemable means repayable. When the company is going to redeem its debentures, means repayment of the principal amount. Suppose Mr. Ram purchased 10,000 debentures from the company at the rate of 100 each. Means one debenture cost 100 rupees and one person is purchasing 1,000 number of debentures from the company. So that person invested 1,000 into 100, 1 lakh rupees debenture he purchased. So here the agreement takes place between the company and the person that the company has to repay 1 lakh rupees, the principal amount, on a specified date. Means after 1 year or after 2 years or after 3 years, when the company is going to repayment the principal amount. And also the company has to pay the fixed amount of interest to the debenture holder. How will you know the what percent of the interest is provided by the company? In the debentures written that 9% debenture, so 9% interest. 10% debenture, 10% interest, the company has to pay half yearly or annually. After half a year, the company has to pay 6 months debentures, interest on debentures. And also, suppose the company is paying after 1 year, then the annually interest has to pay by the company. The company has to pay annual interest or maybe half yearly interest to the debenture holder. So debenture holders are entitled to get fixed rate of interest. Whether the company having the loss or maybe profit, but the debenture holders are entitled to get fixed rate of interest. But when one person is purchasing the shares, equity shares, then the company, if the company having the profit, then only the shareholders are entitled to get dividend. Shareholders are getting dividend, but debenture holders are getting interest. Out of profit, the company has to pay the dividend. But here, the debenture holders are entitled to get fixed rate of interest as the specified rate until the principal sum is repaid. Till the principal sum is not repaid, the company has to pay the interest. Now we'll compare about the debentures and the shares. Debentures, it is a loan of a company. Means the debenture holders are the creditor of the company. But share, it is a part of owner's capital, because the company's capital is divided into two parts. One is share, one is the borrowed fund, and another is the owner's capital. So in owner's capital, the share capital and the reserves and surplus are coming. But the borrowed capital, whatever the company borrowing from the outsider, so debenture is a debt, the company is borrowing from the outside parties. Second point is there, debentures are redeemable. Redeemable means repayable. The company has to repay the principal sum or the principal amount on a specified date before the dissolution of the company. So debentures are the redeemable. Redeemable means repayable after a specified period of time. But equity shares are not redeemable. Means the equity shareholders, their capital may not be repayable. Whatever the amount, whatever the shareholder invested the money in the company, it may be redeemable or may not be redeemable. Means it may be repayable or may not be repayable during the lifetime of the company. When the company will dissolve, the company has to pay back first the debenture holder, preference share capital, outside liabilities, the bank loans or any outside parties, suppose the company has taken loans, after that only the equity shares are redeemable. So understand the difference? Debentures are the redeemable and equity shares are not redeemable during the lifetime of the company. It is a permanent source of capital, the equity share. Third point is that debentures can be issued at a discount. Discount means the market value of the debentures is less than the face value. So debentures can be issued at a discount, but shares cannot be issued at a discount. Means the market value should not be less than the face value. The shares cannot be issued at a discount. Debentures may be converted into shares. Suppose you have 1 lakh rupees, you have invested by purchasing the debentures and debenture cost is 100 rupees. You are getting the fixed rate of interest from the company. But after some years, you are thinking that you have to take the risk so that you can earn more and more profit. When it is possible? When the company earnings more and more amount of profit, then the shareholders are entitled to get more and more amount of dividend, because dividend is not fixed. It fluctuates. When the company having more and more amount of profit, the shareholder will get more and more amount of dividend. Suppose when the company is earning huge amount of profit, then you can convert your debentures into shares so that you can gain more and more amount of dividend. But if you purchase shares, these shares cannot be converted into debentures. So debentures may be converted into shares, but shares cannot be converted into debentures. These are the difference between debentures and shares, because you can know about totally how the debentures capital is totally different from the share capital. Debentures are the borrowed fund, what the company is borrowing from the outsiders. But share capital is owner's capital, the company's shares. Next, it is only giving the example about one slide, the debenture certificate. When one person is purchasing debentures from the company will issue just like a certificate that it is a proof that you purchase this much amount of debentures, or you are given this much amount of loan to the company. So it is an acknowledgement of debt, or it is a proof of debt. It is the debenture certificate. It is the example. You have, just like in the fixed deposit, you are getting one certificate. Next come to what the difference between the shareholder and debenture holder. Same thing, ownership. Shareholders are the owners of the company, because when one person is purchasing the shares, they are called the owners of the company. Why? Because they are getting profit of the company as terms as the dividend. But debenture holders, they are the lender of the company. Means the company is taking loan from the debenture holder, or debenture holders are the lenders. They are providing loans to the company. So debenture holders are not the owner of the company. They are the lender who provides loans. But shareholders are the owners. Form of return. When a shareholder is investing some amount by purchasing shares from the company, the shareholders are entitled to get dividend in the form of return. You invested, suppose, 2 lakh rupees in the company. The company decided to give the dividend 10%. So 2 lakhs, 10%, 20,000 rupees, you are getting dividend from the company. It is the form of return, whatever the amount you have invested in the company. But debenture holders, in the form of return is interest. Means the debenture holders are entitled to get fixed rate of interest. Means the company has to pay fixed rate of interest, 9% or 10%, whatever decided by the company. And what is the agreement between the company and the debenture holders? Whether the company earns profit or loss, the company has to pay interest to the debenture holders. Security. Shareholders not secured. Why? Because when the company issues shares and the equity shareholders are not redeemable or not repayable, during the lifetime of the company. So it is not secured. Suppose you have invested 10 lakh rupees by purchasing shares from the company and you become the shareholder. So your 10 lakh rupees is not repaid by the company till the dissolution of the company. During the lifetime of the company, you will not get back your capital. So it is not secure. The company is dissolved. Then the company has to pay the amount of capital first to the debenture holder. Then the company will pay to the outside liabilities. Then the company has to repay the bank loans. If anything left, then only the shareholders are entitled to get back their capital. But if you purchase debentures from the company, your investment is secured. How it is secured? Secured by a charge on assets. Means if you have purchased 10 lakh rupees or you have invested 10 lakh rupees by purchasing debentures, company's total assets, the plant and machinery, total property of the company is mortgaged with the debenture holders. Mortgage understood? Suppose you are taking loan from the bank, you have to show the mortgage in the form of land or in the form of gold. By seeing yourself, the company, the bank, banks are not providing you loans. If suppose you are giving the guarantee or any mortgage, you are doing any mortgage of your property, then only the bank will provide you loan. So here the bank is getting the secured loans. Just like when the debenture holders purchasing the debentures, the company's assets are mortgaged with the debenture holder. So your debentures, whatever the investment, is secured. And before dissolution, the company has to repay your capital. So it is secured. Voting rights. On the basis of voting rights, how shareholders and debenture holders are distinguished? Equity shareholders have the voting rights. Full voting rights means the shareholders choose the director of the company who manage the company, because there are many shareholders are there and shareholders also scattered here and there. So they cannot able to manage the company because they are the real owners. The shareholders are the real owners. But due to scattering here and there, the shareholders are not able to manage the company. So they choose their representative called director of the company who manage the company. So the equity shareholder has the right. They have the voting rights. They can choose the director of the company. But the debenture holder, no voting right in normal course of business. They are only the lender of the company. They are providing the loans and advances, but they don't have take any active part in the business management. They don't have rights to get any active part. They cannot take any decision. So that is the voting rights. They have voting rights. Debenture holders don't have voting rights. Risk. Risk is more as compared to the debenture holders. Why? Because the shareholders' dividend is depend upon the profit of the company. And their capital, the shareholders' capital, whatever they invested in the company, it is not repayable or it is not redeemable during the lifetime of the company. So they are having the more risk. But debenture holder is the risk free. Why? Because the debenture holders are entitled to get fixed rate of interest as their return. And due to the secured debentures, their money, whatever invested in the company, it is secured because the assets are mortgaged with the debenture holder. So secured by a charge on assets. So these are the differences between the shareholders and the debenture holders. Next come to what are the different types of debentures? Any persons willing to purchase the debentures from the company, generally what happens, the debentures face value is high, but the face value of the shares is low as compared to the debentures. The cost of debentures, one debenture, suppose 100 rupees, cost of one debenture and cost of one shares, maybe 10 rupees, like this. means the face value of the debentures is high. And there are different types of, just like you have learned maybe before chapters, about the equity shares. The shares are equity shares, preference shares. And preference shares also having the different types, cumulative, non-cumulative, participating preference shares, non-participating preference shares. Just like similarly, there are different types of debentures also there. First one is the security point of view. One is secured debenture and another one is unsecured debenture. Then on the redemption point of view, one is redeemable debentures and irredeemable debentures. And registration point of view, one is registered debenture, another one is the bearer debenture. And according to the convertibility point of view, the debentures can be convertible into shares or may not be convertible into, the shares cannot be convertible into debentures. I taught before just only. So convertibility, on the basis of the convertibility point of view, the debentures may be convertible or may be non-convertible. So now we'll teach you about issue of debentures. What are the procedure and what are the accounting entries for issuing debentures? So the procedure and the accounting entries for the issuing of debentures are same as that of issue of shares. Just like when issuing the company, issuing the shares, the company is getting or the raising the funds through the shares, the company can get first the application money. Then when the company is allotting the shares, then the company asks for the allotment of money. Then after some months, then the company asks for the first call, then second call and final call. In the different installments, the company has to arrange the funds from the shareholder. Means who purchased the shares, the shareholder pay first application money, then allotment money, then first call, then second call, then final call money. So the intending subscribers first apply for the debentures. Suppose you want to purchase the debentures from the company. So you are the intending subscriber. You want to purchase the debentures from the company. So you have to apply that you want to purchase a debenture. How to apply? Apply on a prescribed form, which is deposited along with the application amount. Suppose one debenture cost is 100 rupees. The company is issuing debenture each at the rate of 100, means one debenture cost is rupees 100. And you want to purchase, suppose, 1000 debentures. So you don't have to pay 100 multiply 1000, 1 lakh rupees at a time to the company. If the company is asking for installment payment, so there what happened, the 100 rupees is divided into different installments. Suppose with the application it is 20, one debenture cost 100 rupees and the company divided these 100 rupees into different parts. First part, suppose 20 rupees for application. Second, suppose allotment part, suppose 50 rupees. 20 plus 50 is 70. Rest left 30 rupees. First call may be 20 rupees. Final call may be 10 rupees. Like this, in the four installments, the company will collect 100 rupees for each and one debenture. So when suppose you want to purchase 1000 debenture and the cost of application is suppose 20 rupees, you have to pay 1000 into 20, 20,000 rupees as application money. At a time, you don't have to pay the 100 rupees for one debenture. So in the prescribed form, the debenture holder deposited with details about you and what number of debentures you want to purchase along with the application amount, means 1000 multiplied 20. 20,000 you have to deposit along with the form. And the company may ask the payment of the total amount along with the application or by installments. The company may ask you that you have to pay at a time 100 rupees one debenture. He wants to purchase 1,000 debenture. So 1 lakh rupees at a time you have to pay. Or maybe the company asks that you have to pay on the installment basis. So the total amount along with the application or by installments. Understood? So these debentures can be issued. When that company issued the debentures, the company may ask for the payment of the total amount maybe along with the application or maybe with the installments. So these debentures can be issued for cash. Sometimes the debentures can be issued for cash means when the company wants to increase the capital, the company may issue debentures for cash. Second, the company may issue for consideration other than cash. And third one is the as collateral security. We'll read details just now. Now, just only before I explain you what are the types of debentures. So first one is the convertibility point of view. There are two types of debentures. One is convertible debentures. Another is non-convertible debentures. Convertible debentures, which can be converted into equity shares of the issuing company after a predetermined period of time. When a debenture holder wants to convert into equity shares, whatever amount invested in by purchasing the debentures, the investors or the debenture holder wants to convert it into equity shares, the debenture holders only can convert into equity shares after a predetermined period of time according to the terms and conditions. Not that immediately now you purchase debentures from the company and after 1 month he wants to convert into the equity shares. No, it cannot be possible. So the debenture holders can be converted into equity shares or the debentures can be converted into equity shares after a predetermined period of time. And these may be partly convertible debentures. You may, total 1,000 debentures you purchased, 300 debentures may be converted into shares. So a part of these instruments are converted into equity shares in the future. And the issuer decides the ratio for conversion also. You can do the ratio. So 1,000 debenture, 3:2 ratio, suppose you want to convert. So 3 shares means 3/5 × 1,000. 600 debentures can be converted into equity shares. And rest of this, it will be made in the form of the shares only. So this is not decided at the time of subscription. Fully convertible debentures. These are the fully convertible into equity shares means whatever the debentures you purchase, it may be converted full amount of debentures, whatever amount you invested, totally converted into equity shares. And the ratio of the conversion is decided by the issuer, which issuing, he will decide. Upon conversions, the investors enjoy the same status as ordinary shareholder of the company. When your debentures are converted into equity shares, then you enjoy the status of the shareholder, not the debenture holder, because your debentures are totally converted into shares. So your status also changes. You are from the debenture holder, you are becoming the shareholder. So now you are becoming the owner of the company. And you have the full voting rights. That is called fully convertible debenture. Non-convertible debenture, which are simply regular debentures and cannot be converted into equity shares. And these are debentures without the convertibility features. Means it cannot be convertible into shares. And these usually carry higher interest rate. The non-convertible debentures generally carry higher interest rate. Means they are getting higher interest from the company annually or half yearly than the convertible counterparts. Means one person is purchasing the convertible debenture, another person is purchasing the non-convertible debentures, then the non-convertible debentures are getting higher rate of interest as compared to the fully convertible debentures. Next one is the secured debentures on the basis of security. These instruments are secured by a charge on the fixed assets of the issuer company. Means the company's assets are mortgaged, the fixed assets are mortgaged with the debenture holder. If issuer fails to pay either the principal or the interest amount, means when the company is failed to pay the principal money, whatever invested by the public or any persons, or the company is failed to pay the fixed amount of interest annually, then its assets can be sold to repay the liability towards the debenture holders. Means whatever invested by the debenture holders, if the company is not able to repay the principal amount and interest amount, then the debenture holder has the right to sell the property, right to sell the fixed assets of the company to get back their capital or to get back their liability. When you purchase secured debentures. But unsecured debentures, these instruments are unsecured in the sense that if the company defaults on payments of the interest, when the company is not able to repay the interest money or the principal amount, then the investor is treated as other unsecured creditor of the company from the redemption point of view. Means, sorry, from unsecured debenture basis. Means the company's assets are not mortgaged with the debenture holder. Means debenture holders don't have the right to sell the assets of the company to get back their money. That is called unsecured. Next one is the redeemable debentures. Redeemable means repayable. Redeemable debentures are those debentures which are redeemed or paid off or repayable after the termination of fixed term. When the company is issuing debentures, the company having the condition that the company, when the company is going to paid off or repayable or redeemable the debentures after 3 years or after 4 years or after 5 years, having a fixed term. So after 3 years, the company has to repay the money or repay the capital amount. That is called the redeemable debentures. Suppose you purchase the redeemable debentures with the condition that 3 years back, after 3 years, you will get back your capital. So the company has to return the full amount, the principal amount after 3 years. That is called redeemable debentures. The amount paid off includes the principal amount and the current year's interest, because the debenture holders are entitled to get fixed rate of interest. Every year the company has to pay fixed amount of interest to the debenture holders. And the company always has the option of either to redeem a specific number of debentures each year or redeem all the debentures at a specified date. That means when you purchase, suppose 1,000 debentures, having the terms and conditions, the company may redeemable or repayable the debentures, 300 debentures this year, more left 700 debentures, next year maybe 700 debentures. So totally 1,000 debentures the company is repaid after 2 years. Either the company can redeemable total 1,000 debentures after 3 years. So the company always have the option of either to redeem a specific number of debentures each year. About 1,000 debentures, maybe this year 500 and next year 500 debentures, or maybe redeemed all the debentures at specified date, means in 1 year. That is called the redeemable debentures. Next is the irredeemable or perpetual debentures. Irredeemable debentures means which do not have any fixed date of redemption. Means the company is not going to redeem the debentures. The company don't have conditions that in this date the company has to redeem or has to repayable or has to repay the capital to the debenture holders, whatever invested by the debenture holders. So they are redeemed either in the event of the winding off, means the company may repay the capital to the debenture holders, whatever money invested by the debenture holders, in the event of the winding off, means when the company is wound up, or when the company is dissolved, or when the company is closed, then only the company will repay the principal amount to the debenture holders. An irredeemable or perpetual debenture can never force the company to redeem that debenture. You suppose purchase irredeemable debentures, then you cannot force the company to repay your capital in between of the company. After the winding of the company, then only you will get back your capital if you purchase irredeemable debenture. But suppose you purchase redeemable debentures, the company has to repay your money, repay your principal sum after fixed term. Next, come to the how the company is issuing the debentures. The debentures can be issued at par, at premium, or at discount. So when the debentures are issued at par, means the market value and the face value of the debentures are same. Means when the face value of one debenture cost 100 rupees, then the company issue the debenture at 100 only. That means the market value of debenture is also 100. Who wants to purchase the debentures from the company? They have to pay 100 rupees per debenture. That is called debenture issued at par. But when debenture issued at premium, means debenture are issued at premium, means that the value of the debenture issued is more than its face value. 100 rupees one debenture cost, the market value may be 110 or maybe 120 or maybe 130. So debentures are issued at premium means the face value, sorry, the market value of the debenture is more than the face value. Generally, the premium is collected at the time of allotment only. When one person wants to purchase the debentures from the company, that person has to pay the application money. Then the company will decide this person will be allotted share or not. So after allotment, allotment of debenture or not. But when the company wants to alert the debentures to a particular person, that time only the premium is collected. So the journal entries or the accounting entries for the premium is done at the time of allotment money. So therefore, the entry relating to the allotment will change. The new entry will be given that when allotment money is due, suppose when the allotment money is due in the shares, you are passing the journal entry, debenture allotment account debit, the share allotment account debit to share capital account. Just like similarly, when the allotment money is due in the case of debentures, debenture allotment account debit to debenture account. And two, debenture premium account. Whatever the extra money is collected by the company, it is transferred to a separate account called debenture premium account. And the face value, suppose the 1,000 debentures company issued at the rate of 100 each, one debenture cost 100 each, and the company issued at a premium 30%. Means the cost of or the market value of the debentures becomes 130 rupees, because 100 is 30% premium, 30 rupees extra, 130 rupees. So the debenture allotment account debit 1000 multiply 130, total money due 1000 multiply 130, this total amount is due from the debenture holder. To debenture account, it is coming the face value. 1000 multiply 100 only. And the extra 30 rupees, 1000 into 30, it will be transferred to separate account called debenture premium account. So two debenture premium account. And when the company is receiving total amount from the debenture holder, then money is coming, bank account debit, you know how to pass the journal entry, the rules of journal entries. So bank account debit, because money is coming to the company, real account, bank account debit, whatever money is coming to debenture allotment account, means the allotment money is received. It is in the case of debenture issued at premium. Debenture issued at discount means when the company issue a debentures at less than the face value, 100 rupees one debenture cost, and the company issuing debenture suppose at the rate of 90 each, so 10 rupees less than the face value. The debenture is issued at a discount when the amount of debenture received is less than its face value. And the discount on debenture is allowed at the time of allotment only, just like the premium money is collected at the time of allotment. The discount on debenture also allowed at the time of allotment. So at the time of discount, the journal entry, debenture allotment account debit, the total money is due. About 1000 debentures, one debenture face value is 100 rupees and discount support 10%. 100, 10% is 10 rupees. The company is giving discount you 10 rupees. So what allotment money is due from the company? 1000 multiply 90 rupees. And the rest 10 rupees is discount on issue of debentures. And to debenture account, the full face value of the money. And when the total money is received by the company, then the bank account debit to debenture allotment account, being allotment money is received. So total money is received by the company. Sometimes what happened, when I explained you before, the debentures money is received in lump sum money as with the application money, or the company can get the money on the installment basis. Means application money, then allotment money, then first call, then second call, then final call. So when the amount of debenture is received in lump sum as application money, so the company is asking 100 rupees, suppose one debenture cost, the company is asking totally at a time 100 rupees for each debenture. Not application money 30, after some months again allotment money 20, again after some months first call, then again after some months final call. Not like this installment basis. When the company wants money at lump sum, the company can collect the total money at a time. That time what entry will pass? Bank account debit, because the total money is coming. So bank account debit to debentures application and allotment account, being the application money received. When this application and allotment money transferred or adjusted, so debenture application and allotment account is before credited, now it is debited. So this account can be closed, application and allotment account, and it is transferred to the debenture account. So 2% debenture account. Percentage means the rate of interest which is finalized by the company. The percentage, it may be 10%, so 10% interest, 9%, 9% interest the company has to pay, because the debenture holders are entitled to get fixed rate of interest. So this percentage indicates the rate of interest. So whatever the application money collected by the company, bank account debit to debenture application allotment account, it is transferred to debenture account, so debenture application allotment account debit to this person debenture account. If suppose more application come, that is called the oversubscription. You have learned in the shares chapter also. When the company issued 10,000 shares to the public and public applied for 12,000 shares. So this is called the oversubscription, means 2,000 applications coming excess, whatever the company issued. Just like in the similar case, just like in the debenture, when the company suppose issuing 10,000 debentures to the public, and the public may apply for 12,000 or 15,000 or may be applied for 8,000. That is called 8,000 is called the under subscription, and when the public applied for 12,000, this is called the over subscription. So if the company issuing 10,000 debentures to the public and the public applied for 12,000 debentures, so this is called the oversubscription, and the 2,000 debentures application money the company received in the excess. So these excess application money the company has to refund to the public, because the company only issuing 10,000 debentures, the company can only allot 10,000 debentures, not 12,000 debentures. But when the public applied for 12,000 debentures, the public may pay, public had already paid excess 2,000 application money of debentures. So the company has to return the excess application money. So the from company money is going, so bank account will be credited. And in the case of the application and allotment account, debited. So debenture application and allotment account debit to bank account. Or maybe in the second entry you can pass debenture application and allotment account debit with the full amount what the company is getting to percentage debenture account, the face value of the money, whatever the company issued, and the excess money to bank account. In second entry also you can write debenture application and allotment account debit to percentage debenture account to bank account. Or maybe you can ask the different entry for excess application money refunded. So debenture application allotment account debit to bank account. I'm giving you an example one. Suppose DTDC LTD, a limited company, issued 20,009% debentures, means here you are purchasing 9% debenture, means you'll get 9% interest of rupees 100 each, means the face value of one debenture cost 100 rupees, and company issuing at par. Par means same, 100 rupees the company issuing. Company issued 20,000 debentures, 100 each at par, payable on application by 1st April 2019. An application was received for 25,000 debentures. So it is over subscription. Means the company issued 20,000 debentures, but application is coming to the company 25,000 debentures. So 5,000 debentures excess application money coming to the company. And all the debentures were allotted on 5th April 2019. And whatever the excess application money was refunded on the same date. So what are the accounting treatments or the accounting journal entries will pass in the books of the company? So when the company issuing 20,000 debentures, but applications were received for 25,000 debentures, the bank account debit, because money is coming. Money is not coming 20,000 debentures. The company is getting money for 25,000 debentures. So 25,000 multiply 100. The company is getting 25 lakhs from the public. The total money is received by company 25 lakh rupees. So bank account debit 25 lakh to debenture application and allotment account, because the company is at a time getting total money, not in the installment basis. Just like in the shares you are doing bank account debit to share application account or equity share application account, whatever money application money you are receiving. Here the company is getting at a time application and allotment money, total money 100 rupees, 25,000 debentures, 100 rupees each, 25 lakh we are getting. After that second entry, debenture application and allotment account debit, because on April 5th April, the debentures are allotted. So the company having the debenture application and allotment money, the company has to close this account by debiting this, because before it was credited. Debenture application and allotment account 25 lakhs. But debenture application and allotment account debit 25 lakh rupees. Two, 9% debenture account, it should be in the face value, because the company is issuing 20,000 debentures and one debenture cost 100 rupees. The company's money only to 20 lakhs rupees, not 25 lakh rupees. So only the company will transfer to debentures account 20 lakh rupees. Excess 5 lakh rupees, this application money, the company has to return to the public. So bank account will be credited 5 lakh rupees, because the company has to return 5 lakh rupees. And this entry may be in the two parts you can do. Suppose three entry will pass. First entry is similar, bank to debenture application allotment account. Second entry and third entry, you can make separate. What? Debenture application and allotment account debit 20 lakh. 29% debenture account 20 lakh. And extra 5 lakh rupees you can return. So next entry you can pass. Debenture application and allotment account debit 5 lakh. To bank account 5 lakh. You can do in the three entries, or it may be two entries. This is one example I given, when the company is getting the full amount, total amount of in with the application. So this is given about the oversubscription of the debenture. When the excess applications are received by the company for the subscription of the debentures, it is known as the oversubscription. In such a case, there are three options available. Reject the excess application. The company can reject the excess application. In this case, the directors may reject the excess application, and the company has to return the excess application money to the applicants. Or the company may allot the shares, just like you read in the shares chapter. When the excess or oversubscription of shares, the company can allot the shares on pro rata basis. Here also the company can allot the debentures on pro rata basis. Means the ratio on which the company can allot the debenture according to the application given by the debenture holder. Means on what ratio the company is allotting the debentures. Means here the company is not returning the money. The excess money will be adjusted. The directors may allot the debentures on the pro rata basis. For example, it's given, Ram has applied for 1,000 debentures, but company has issued only 800 debentures on pro rata basis. Because Ram has applied 1,000 debentures, means it is oversubscription, but company is not allotting to Ram 1,000 debentures. The company only allotting 800 debentures on pro rata basis. So 200 debentures excess money, the company will not return to Ram. The company will be adjusted on the allotment. Here, the company is asking, not asking the total money. The company is asking only the application money. Ram has paid only application money of 1,000 debentures, but the company is allotting him 800 debentures on pro rata basis. And whatever the 200 debentures excess money the Ram has paid, when the Ram has to pay the allotment money, that time the Ram has to deduct the excess money, and Ram has to pay the allotment money, rest amount of allotment money paid by Ram. In this case, applicants do not get the full debentures applied by them, because here Ram is applied for 1,000 debentures, but he is getting only 800 debentures. Company only allotting him 800 debentures. So combination of above two alternatives, this is the combination of the first two methods, where some of the excess application money is rejected by the company, and second one, and the pro rata allotment is made to the remaining applicants. Options are available in this case are, some of the excess application may be rejected, some applicants may get full allotment, some applicants may get allotment on pro rata basis. First case, the company can reject during the oversubscription. Second case, Some applicants may get full allotment. If suppose Shyam applied for 2,000 debentures, the Shyam will allotted 2,000 debentures. And Ram applied suppose 1,000 debentures, Ram is getting 800 debentures. This is the third case. Some applicants may get allotment on prorata basis. Now I'm teaching you about the issue of debentures for consideration other than cash. Other than cash means when the company is purchased assets from another company. So the company has to pay money to the another company because this company is purchased assets. Suppose X Limited purchased assets from Y Limited. So X Limited has to pay money to the Y Limited for purchase of assets. But when X Limited is issuing debentures or issuing shares to the Y Limited and not paying the cash, this is called the debentures are issued for purchase of assets or issue of debentures for consideration other than cash. When the company is purchasing assets from the another company and the company is not paying cash, but instead of paying cash, the company is issuing debentures to the another company for payment of his liability. So when debentures issued for purchase assets at par, when the company is purchasing assets from the vendor, vendor means the creditor, X Limited purchasing assets from the Y Limited, so Y Limited is vendor for X Limited. Y Limited is the creditor for X Limited. So when debentures issued, when the assets are purchased, so what general entry will pass? Assets are coming to the company. So in the books of X Limited, will pass the general entry, sundry asset account debit to vendor account. Because assets are coming, and vendor is the creditor's liability. Liability increases, increase in liability credit. Assets account debit to vendor account with the purchases consideration. Second entry, if suppose the company is paying cash, then vendor account debit to cash account. If the money is paid to the vendor with check, vendor account debit to bank account. But when the company is issuing debentures instead of cash, that is called other than cash. So vendor account debit, that means decrease in liability. Before you pass the entry, vendor account credited. Now you are paying to vendor, vendor account debit to debenture account. Means with the part amount of debentures you are issuing to the vendor. When debentures are issued for purchasers, purchase of assets are premium. So when assets are purchasing, second case, sundry assets account debit to vendor account. Suppose you purchase plant and machinery of rupees 5 lakh from the vendor. So plant and machinery account debit 5 lakh to vendor account 5 lakh. Or maybe sundry assets account debit 5 lakh to vendor account 5 lakh. And when you are issuing the debentures at premium, suppose issuing debentures at par, one debenture cost is 100 rupees. You purchase assets from the vendor 5 lakh rupees. So number of debenture issued to the vendor is 5 lakh divided by 100. So it is coming 5,000. So the company has to issue 5,000 debentures at the rate of 100 each. So you will pass your entry, vendor account debited 5 lakh to debentures account 5 lakh. But when the company issue debentures at premium, 100 debentures but issued at premium, suppose 25% premium. So here the market value of the debentures increases to 100 rupees into 25% is 25 rupees is the premium. The cost of debentures becomes 125. So now what entry will pass when the debentures are issued at premium? First, you'll pass the general entry sundry asset account debit 5 lakh to vendor account 5 lakh. And when the debenture issued at premium, vendor account debit 5 lakh to debenture account. You have to calculate the number of debentures. So now you are issuing less number of debentures because one debenture cost becomes 125 rupees. Because 100 plus 25 rupees premium. So 5 lakh divided by 125. Then to security premium reserve, whatever the number of debentures will come, multiply 25 rupees. The extra money is transferred to the security premium reserve. This entry will pass. But third case is that when business is purchased, when one company is purchased the business from the another company. When purchase consideration is equal to the net value of the assets, suppose sundry asset debit, you purchase the assets, 10 lakh rupees. Total value of sundry asset is 10 lakh. Sundry asset account debit 10 lakh. Sundry liabilities account, increase in liability, suppose 2 lakh. So what money you have to pay? 8 lakh rupees to the vendor. Because you are purchasing assets 10 lakh rupees. The value of asset is 10 lakh. Sundry assets account debit 10 lakh. To sundry liabilities account, suppose 2 lakh. Because you have to pay the liabilities of another company, 2 lakh rupees. So 10 lakh assets purchased, 2 lakh liability you have to pay. 8 lakh rupees you have to pay to the vendor. So to vendor account, 8 lakh rupees. But if vendor is agreed to pay 9 lakh rupees, 10 lakh rupees assets purchasing, liabilities you are paying 2 lakh. 8 lakh rupees you have to pay to the vendor. But terms and conditions is there, that is called the purchase consideration. You have to pay 9 lakh rupees, or the company has to pay 9 lakh rupees to the vendor. Here 1 lakh rupees extra you are paying, or the company is paying extra 1 lakh rupees. Why the company is paying extra for purchase consideration? Due to goodwill of the company, reputation of the company. The company is paying to vendor 1 lakh rupees extra. This goodwill is treated as an assets for the company. So here goodwill account debited 1 lakh. So your entry will be passed. Sundry assets account debit 10 lakh. To sundry liabilities account 2 lakh. To vendor account 9 lakh. And goodwill account will be debited 1 lakh. Because 10 lakh minus 2 lakh, 8 lakh. And your vendor is getting 9 lakh rupees. 1 lakh rupees extra is paid by the company. That is for the goodwill. But another case is, when the company, instead of paying 8 lakh, the company's, the terms and condition for purchase consideration is there, the company has to pay, suppose, 6 lakh. The company has to pay to the vendor 8 lakh, but the companies agree to pay 6 lakh according to the purchase consideration. So it is benefit for the company 2 lakh rupees, because instead of paying vendor 8 lakh, the company is paying 6 lakh. So 2 lakh is the capital profit for the company. This capital profit is transferred to another account called capital reserve. So capital reserve will be credited by 2 lakh. So here what entry will pass? Sundry assets account debit, suppose 10 lakh you purchase assets, 10 lakh rupees debit. To sundry liability, suppose 2 lakh rupees, suppose you are paying 2 lakh rupees. 10 lakh minus 2 lakh, 8 lakh the company has to pay to the vendor. So to, suppose you are paying 6 lakh, so to vendor 6 lakh and to capital reserve 2 lakh. This is the different entries. When you'll do the example, then you'll better understand. Now, issue of debentures as collateral security. Sometimes what happens, the company takes loan from the banks. The company sometimes issue debentures to serve as the collateral security for a loan or for bank overdrafts. The collateral security comes into force only when the principal security fails to pay the given loan. When the company takes loan from the bank and the principal security fails to pay the given loan, then the additional securities issued by the company to the banks. So when the loan is paid, such debentures revert back to the company. So we can deal with the issue of debentures as collateral security in the following two ways. No journal entries pass when the company does not make journal entry in its book of accounts regarding the issue of debentures, because here the debentures are issued. Debentures are not acknowledgement of debt, because here the company issued the additional security for taking the loans. So here the company does not make any journal entry in the books of the accounts regarding the issue of debentures. So therefore, the only transaction that the company will record in its books will be of loan against which the company issued these debentures. When the company is taking the loans from the bank, loan is the liability for the company. So loan account will be credited. The company's bank account is increases, the bank account debit. So when the company is taking loan, bank account debit to loan account. When the company passes a journal entry in its book on taking the loan. And second case, suppose when the journal entry is when the company journal entry pass as collateral securities. When the company took loan from the bank, bank account debit to bank loan account. And on the issue of debentures as collateral securities, the debenture suspense account is debited to debentures account. If the company takes loan from the bank, from SBI, State Bank of India, 20 lakhs rupees suppose taken by the company from State Bank of India. So journal entry passed by the company, bank account debit 20 lakhs to bank loan account 20 lakhs. Because the company is taking loan from the bank. Bank account debit to bank loan account 20 lakhs. And when the company is issuing the debentures as collateral securities as 25 lakhs, when the company issued debentures as collateral security of 25 lakh rupees, suppose, then debenture suspense account debit 25 lakhs to debentures account 25 lakhs. These two entries will be passed for debenture issued as collateral securities for taking loan and for issuing of debentures as collateral securities. These two entries only passed by the company. Next, come to the interest on debentures. Just I'll explain you, the shareholders are entitled to get dividend, but the debenture holders are entitled to get interest. The interest on debentures is paid maybe half yearly or maybe annually. The company has to pay the fixed rate of interest according to the terms and conditions between or agreement between the debenture holders and the company. Whether the company has the profit or loss, the company has to pay interest, fixed interest. The interest is taxable according to the Companies Act. Interest is an income for the debenture holder, because debenture holder invested some amount in the company and they are entitled to get interest every year or half yearly. This is one of the income for the debenture holder. And interest is taxable according to the Companies Act. So what are the journal entries are passed when the interest is due and interest is paid and when income tax is paid to the governments for the taxes, because it's a taxable income? Interest due to the debenture holder, what journal entry will pass? Debenture interest account debit to debenture holder account to income tax payable account. Suppose one debenture holder purchase 2000 debentures of 100 each. So 2000 into 100. 2 lakh rupees the debenture holder invested in the company. It is the acknowledgement of debt for the company. And the company suppose has to pay interest 10%. So 2 lakhs 10% is 20,000. So 20,000 is the interest. So interest due to debenture holder, interest account debit, or debenture interest account debit 20,000. To debenture holder account after tax suppose paying 5%. So 20,000 is 5%. 1,000 will be credited to the income tax payable account. Rest 19,000 will be credited to the debenture holder account. So interest, debenture interest account debit 20,000. To debenture holder account 19,000, to income tax payable 1,000. If income tax is paid 5% on 20,000 interest. And when the interest is paid to the debenture holder, so from the company money is going, so bank account be credited and debenture holder account debited. And whatever money is the tax is payable to the government, income tax payable account debit to bank account. Or maybe at a time you can pass the entry, debenture holder account debit 19,000, income tax payable account debit 1,000, to bank account 20,000. Or maybe separate entry, debenture holder account debit 19,000, to bank account 19,000, and another entry, income tax payable account 1,000, to bank account 1,000. And this interest is transferred to statement of PL because it is expenses for the company. So how will it transfer? Statement, it is transferred to the statement of PL. The company is preparing statement of PL. So statement of PL account debit to debenture interest account. These are the three entries passed on interest on debenture. Same thing, just I'm making them the other ways. For making interest due, interest on debenture account debit to debenture holder account. For making payment of interest and the debentures, TDS means tax deductible sources. When the company is deducting the taxes of the debenture holder's interest, the debenture holder account debited, what amount is due to the debenture holder? And after deducting the tax, whatever amount of tax is deducting by the company, so to TDS payable account, just I given, suppose interest is getting supposed by the debenture holder 20,000. So for making interest due, interest on debenture account debit 20,000 to debenture holder account 20,000, because the company has to pay 20,000 to the debenture holder. When the company is paying 20,000 rupees interest to the debenture holders, so here debenture holders account debit 20,000. And to bank account, after deducting the tax suppose 1,000, the company is paying 19,000 to the debenture holder, so to bank account 19,000, and to TDS payable or tax deductible sources 1,000. And for making payments of TDS, you can pass the separate entry also, TDS payable account debit to bank account 1,000. And this transferring interest to the profit and loss statement, not account, profit and loss statement, the company passes statement of PL account debit to interest on debenture account. Sir, we'll close.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, sir. Any doubts or anything regarding that? Because today
actually,
I have. Yes, sir.
Doubts through. I am reading it out. Learner has asked, what is bond?
Burned.
Yes, sir. B-O-N-D.
Burned is... Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sir, please, sir.
Sound is actually not coming properly. It's a burned. It is just like an agreement because it is a negotiable instrument. Burned. Just like the shares, when the company issuing shares and the shareholder wants to purchase the shares, they have become the shareholders and they are getting the dividend from the company. And this is the owner's capital. Debentures is acknowledgement of debt. It is a proof of debt taken by the company from the debenture holders. But bond is the different one. Bond is an agreement take place and is one negotiable instrument. It is transferred to another person. Bond means it is an agreement takes place between the company and the bondholder. That is a negotiable instrument. This is a separate instrument. Just like the bills of exchange. Bill of exchange also one kind of negotiable instrument. It is a written agreement between the company and the bondholder. Bond is different from the debentures.
Thank you, sir. Sir, there is another question. What is the basic purpose behind issue of debentures?
Yes. When the company started, the new company, generally what happened? They need huge amount of capital to start its business. So when the new company started its business, the company cannot issue the debenture. They are having the terms and condition. The company only issue the equity shares because that time when the company don't have to take the risk, the company wants to accumulate the capitals by issuing the equity shares because when the company issue the equity shares, if the company having the profit, then only the company can pay the dividend. So the company don't want to take the risk. If the company having the losses, the company don't have to pay the dividend to the equity shareholders. But after day-to-day activities, after some years, elapse of some times, when the company wants to increase the capital, when the company wants to expand its business, then the company can take loan from the bank, or the company can issue the debentures, or the company can accept the deposits from the public. So here the company will see if the interest rate of the bank is high and the company has to take the loans from the bank because the company has to pay more amount of interest to the bank. That time the company can take loan from the public by issuing of debentures by paying less amount of interest. Because the company is running after 4 or 5 years, whatever many years, after some years, the company wants to expand its business, thus the company can take loans from the, instead of taking loans from the bank, the company can issue debentures, means taking loan from the public and the company has to pay fixed rate of interest and the interest rate is low as compared to the bank loan. So that time the company only issue the debentures. Because why the company will think, why to give the more interest amount to the bank? Why not issue the debentures, it'll take loan from the public and has to pay the fixed rate of interest, a less amount of interest. That time the company issue.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you for a nice session. And I would like to also thank Nishant for the technical support. And the learners must immensely be benefited from this session. And now it is the official announcement of closing of the session. And may I request all the participants to please disengage and disconnect from the session. Thank you, sir. Thank you all.
Okay, sir. Okay, thank you.